I thought I had a pineapple curse. I'd bring home a bunch of fruit and let it sit on the counter to ripen, and my peaches and cantaloupe ended up delicious. But my pineapples were always awful. That's because I didn't know then what I do now about how and why fruit ripens. Welcome to Minute Earth. You see, plants have a reproductive problem. Since they're stuck in place, many of them rely on animals to gulp down their seeds and move them, often unceremoniously, to where the seeds have room and resources to grow. But plants don't want critters to chow down too early. Seeds that get carried away before they have what they need to sprout are wasted. One answer to this dilemma, is fruit. Before the seeds are ready, a fruit's thick skin, hard flesh, bitter chemical compounds, and camouflage work like a defense system to ward off critters. But once the seeds are mature, the fruit starts to transform. Its skin begins to thin, and its hard, bitter flesh starts turning into soft, sweet deliciousness. A scrumptious smell and flashy pigments are the metaphorical cherry on top of the cherry. By the end of this transformation, which we call ripening, the fruit is no longer a deterrent. It's an irresistible bribe for seed dispersers. But not all fruits go from yuck to yum by the same mechanism. It's literally a matter of comparing apples and oranges. Some fruits, like oranges and pineapples, ripen by importing sugars and ripening hormones from other parts of the plant. As the fruit pulls in more of these ingredients, it continues to get tastier and more tempting. But once the fruit falls or gets picked and it's no longer connected to the plant, ripening stops. That's why trying to ripen a pineapple in my kitchen was fruitless. At harvest, it was already as tasty as it was going to get and was just going bad on my counter. But other fruits, like apples and bananas, don't need to be hooked up to a plant to get tastier. They can essentially ripen cordlessly. By the time their seeds are mature, these fruits have already stored up tons of starch that they can convert into sweet sugars. And the hormone that coordinates this conversion, a gas called ethylene, is produced by the fruit itself, and can even get absorbed from other cordless fruits ripening nearby. So sure, a banana can ripen on its plant, but since it doesn't need any additional resources from the plant, it can also ripen on the forest floor or your countertop, which seems pretty convenient. So why aren't all fruits cordless? We aren't exactly sure, but one idea is that fruit is better off ripening where its dispersers hang out. For instance, mangoes, big fruits whose big seeds are generally dispersed by big ground-dwelling critters, probably benefit big time from being able to ripen on the ground. But cherries, whose tiny seeds are usually dispersed by small tree-dwelling animals, may be better off ripening up high, still plugged in. Of course, most modern humans don't dwell on the canopy or the forest floor, but rather in the supermarket, where we have easy access to tons of different fruits. But that makes it hard to know how all these fruits ripen. While you can make some pretty good educated guesses, here's some help to make your fruit-eating experience that much more fruitful.